Hello everyone, namaste from Joy of Reading. Today's story is The Fascinating Fibonaccis. The author is Dr. Shonali Chinnaya. Illustrator is Hari Kumar Nair and publisher is Pratham Books. Fibonaccis, what are they and what is extremely interesting or fascinating about them? Let us see. Numbers. We use them every day to count, measure, call friends on the phone, and even to find out what something costs. But did you know you can also use numbers to create patterns, geometrical shapes, rangoli designs, and more? Did you know number patterns can be seen within patterns in nature? So, numbers are something that we use every day. When we have to count something, count the number of idlis you have to eat, or measure your height, or call friends on the phone. And even when we are handling money, we use numbers everywhere. But did you know that you can use these numbers to create patterns? What are patterns? They are some form of repeated designs, actually. But with numbers also, you can form patterns. So, we'll see what these number patterns actually mean. But first, what is a number pattern? A number pattern is a sequence of numbers where each number is connected to the previous one in one specific way. Take this very simple number pattern, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and so on. How is each number in the sequence connected to the one before it? Well, every number in the sequence is the previous number with one added to it. Here's another number pattern, 14, 12, 10, 8, 6, and so on. Each number in this sequence is the previous number with two subtracted from it. So a number pattern is nothing but a series or a sequence of number, and where each number, every number in the series is connected to the previous one in only one specific way. And what is it? Let's see how it is then. So take this series of numbers or a sequence of numbers, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1 is one more than 0. 2 is one more than 1. 3 is one more than 2, meaning 0 plus 1 is 1, 1 plus 1 is 2, 2 plus 1 is 3, 3 plus 1 is 4, and so on. So you get the next number by adding 1 to the previous number. So the next number here, what will it be? 4 plus 1, 5. After 5, what will we have? 5 plus 1, 6. Yes. Now there's another number pattern, 14, 12, 10. How do we get 12 from 14? When I subtract 2 from 14. How do I get 10 from 12? When I subtract 2 from 12. Similarly, 10 minus 2 is 8. 8 minus 2 is 6. So what should come after 6? 6 minus 2? Yes, 4. And what should come after 4? 4 minus 2? 2. So on. So each number in this sequence is the previous number which has 2 subtracted from it. So this is another number pattern that we are seeing. Now, for a slightly more tricky pattern, 0, 1, 3, 6, 10, 15, and so on. How does this sequence work? Let's see. 0 plus 1 is equal to 1. 1 plus 2 is equal to 3. 3 plus 3 is equal to 6. 6 plus 4 is 10. 10 plus 5 is equal to 15. Do you see the pattern here? What will the next number in this sequence be? Yes, 21, because 15 plus 6 is equal to 21. So look at this pattern, 0, 1, 3, 6. How do I get the next number in this pattern? So first, when I add 1 to 0, I get 1. Nice. But if I add 1 again to 1, I get 2, not 3. But if I add 1 plus 2, I get 3. And let's see, Can I add 3 plus 2 and I get the next number? No, but I have to add 3 plus 3 is equal to 6. And if I add 4 to 6, I get 10. And if I add 5 to 10, I get 15. So you can see this logic in this table or in the sequence here. So to get the next number, first we add 1, you get 1. Then to 1, you add 2, you get 3. To 3, you add 3, you get 6. To 6, you add 4. And you get 10, and to 10 you add 5, you get 15. So you can see that you're consistently adding an increased number, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So to 15, what do I have to add? Yes, 6. So 15 plus 6, I'll get the next number as 21. Now, if I have to get the next number from 21, what should I add? I've added till so far 6. So 21 plus 7, yes. So 28 would be the next number. So this is a slightly tricky pattern or a complex pattern. Now, let's take the number pattern we just discussed. 1, 3, 6, 10, 15, and so on, and see if we can create a shape pattern from it. We can. We now have a shape pattern of triangles that get bigger and bigger as we increase the number of dots according to our number pattern. A number pattern has become a shape pattern. So let's take the same sequence we saw in the previous page, 1, 3, 6, 10. So we take just one dot. Next, we take the number 3. We can get 3 dots. And if I put 2 on the base and 1 on the top, I can draw a triangle. Now let's take the next number in the sequence, 6. I place 3 numbers in the bottom, 2 numbers next, 1. I get a bigger triangle. Then I take the next number in the sequence, which is 10. So I put 4, 3 dots, 2 dots, 1 dot, and I get even a bigger triangle. So the next number is 15. So I put 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, which is 15. So from a number pattern, I have now made it into a shape pattern. Isn't that cool? If you found that interesting, it's time you were introduced to a beautiful number sequence called the Fibonacci or Hemachandra sequence of numbers. The Fibonacci sequence of numbers goes like this: 0, 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13, 21, 34, and so on. You might want to pause the video here and see if you can find out this pattern, but no, don't read below though. Otherwise, now I'm going to continue with the reading. Can you find the pattern that connects these numbers? Yes, every number in the Fibonacci sequence is the sum of the two numbers before it, like this. So first is 0, second is 1, right? 0 plus 1 is equal to 1, you get the third number. 1 plus 1, the second and the third number, if you add, you get 2, which is the fourth number. 1 plus 2 or 2 plus 1 is equal to 3, 2 plus 1 is equal to 3. And then you have 3 plus 5 is equal to 8. 5 plus 8 is equal to 13. 8 plus 13 is equal to 21. 13 plus 21 is equal to 34. And that's how you get the pattern. Got it? Good. Now for the really interesting part, linking this number pattern to patterns in nature. So this is the Fibonacci sequence. And how do you get the next number? As I showed you, 0 plus 1 is 1. 1 plus 1 is 2. 1 plus 2 is 3. 2 plus 3 is 5. 3 plus 5 is 8. 5 plus 8 is 13. And so on. So to get the next number, you add the previous two numbers to get the next number. Isn't that a cool sequence? So try to pause the video here and try to work the sequence on your own. All you have to do is first take 0 and 1. So 0 plus 1 is 1. Next, you add 1 plus 1, you get 2, the next sequence. Then 1 plus 2, you get 3. 2 plus 3, you get 5. So try forming the sequence at least for up to like 20 numbers or so. The number of petals flowers have are often linked to Fibonacci numbers. Can you think of flowers with 1, 3, and 5 petals? These are all Fibonacci numbers. Here are some examples to help you along. So, 1 petal, so 1 and 2, Anthurium, and 2 is Calla lilies. 3 petals, 3 is Bougainvillea, 4 is Clovers. 5 petals are 5, Temple Tree, 6, Hibiscus, 7 is Jasmine. So you can find these various flowers that have petals according to the numbers in the Fibonacci sequence. Isn't that wonderful? Flowers with 2 petals are not very common. The crown of thorns, which you see here, is one example. Flowers with 4 petals, 4 is not a Fibonacci number, are also rare. Count the petals of flowers that you come across and see for yourself. The most interesting flower of all, where the Fibonacci sequence is concerned, is the daisy. Different daisy species have 13, 21, or 34 petals, which are all Fibonacci numbers. So daisy is another flower which has white petals and with a yellow in the middle. And if you look at these different flowers, you will find the number of petals could vary between the flowers, but they are all, the number is always part of the Fibonacci sequence. You should count next time when you look at daisies at how many petals they have, okay? There are even more complex and stunning patterns in nature that appear to be based on the Fibonacci numbers. If you are willing to do a little math, you can see it for yourself. Shall we try it out? Now, what would we get if we squared each of the numbers in the Fibonacci sequence? What does squared mean? When you multiply a number by itself, the number is squared. Fibonacci sequence, 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13, etc. If we squared each of these numbers, we would get 1 into 1 is equal to 1 squared, or 1 squared is equal to 1. 2 into 2 is equal to 2 squared, or 2 squared is equal to 4. 3 into 3 is equal to 3 squared, or 3 squared is equal to 9. 5 into 5 is equal to 5 squared, or 5 squared is equal to 25. 8 into 8 is equal to 8 squared, or 8 squared is equal to 64. 13 into 13 is equal to 13 squared, or 13 squared is equal to 169. So the Fibonacci sequence squared is 1, 4, 9, 25, 64, 169, etc. So we are now going to do a simple exercise. We are going to square all the numbers in the Fibonacci sequence. So 1 squared is 1. What is squared? When the number is multiplied by itself, it's called a square. So 1 squared is equal to 1. 2 squared, which is nothing but 2 into 2, is 4. 3 squared is 3 into 3, 9. And 5 squared, you can see, is 25. 8 squared is 64. So all of these numbers within themselves, we are squaring those numbers. And you get this sequence, 1, 4, 9, 25, 64, 169, so on and so forth. Let us see what is special about this. Now, just like we converted a number pattern into a shape pattern with the triangles before, let's try to convert the Fibonacci sequence squared into a shape pattern. Let's try to draw 1 squared, 2 squared, 3 squared, and so on. 1 squared is easy enough. It is just 1 squared. 2 squared is drawn like this, 2 squares across and 2 squares down. We know that 2 squared is equal to 4, and there are 4 squares in the figure. We call this figure a grid. So what we are going to do with the squares is just like we drew these triangle shapes, right? With that number pattern, now we are going to draw a square with this number pattern. So when it is 1 squared, we just draw 1 square. Now when it is 2 squared, it's equal to 4. So we draw 4 squares like how it is shown here. So 2 across and 2 down, so that it is kind of equal on all sides. Okay, so that is about for 1 squared and 2 squared. Let's go further. Similarly, 3 squared is drawn as 3 squares across and 3 squares down. Again, we know that 3 squared is equal to 9. And there are 9 squares in the grid. 5 squared is drawn as 5 squares across and 5 squares down, making a grid with 25 squares. 8 squared as 8 squares across and 8 squares down, making a grid with 64 squares. 13 squared is drawn as a grid with 169 squares and so on. So now we are going to draw squares of all the other numbers as well in the Fibonacci sequence. So 3 squared is 3 across, 3 down, that makes a total of 9 squares. So this figure here is also called a grid, as we learned in the previous page. So 5 squared is, we have to have 25 squares. So 5 across, 5 down, and we fill this completely. So we have 25 squares in the grid. 8 squared is 64. If you count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So across and down, we have 64 squares in the grid. 13 squared is 169, and we have 13 here across and 13 down, and we have 169 squares in the grid. Now, let's push all the grids we have drawn so far towards each other and arrange them like in the picture. Done. Now draw a smooth curved line from one corner of the smallest grid to its opposite end, as shown in the figure. So what we are going to do, we've drawn all these squares, right? So we had one square, there are 0, 1, 1. So it's the Fibonacci sequence starts with a 0. That doesn't, the square of a 0 is 0. So we don't draw anything. Next number is 1. So 1 square is 1 here. The next number is also 1. So that 1 square is 1 square here. And then followed by 2, 2 into 2 is 4. Then we have the next number 3 in the sequence. So we have the 9 squared. And after that, you have 5 squared, which is 25 squares, and so on. So, and then followed by 8 squared, which is 64, 13 squared, right? So we are placing all these squares next to each other or adjacent, right? Next to each other. And then what we are doing, we are drawing a line from one corner. Look at the picture where I'm pointing. One corner of the square to the opposite corner of the square. So we form a curve. And then again, when we reach the next square, we form another curve. Now we are going into the two squared square. So that one is a bigger curve that we're drawing from this end to this end. So this curve looks like this. Then we go to the three squared from this end to this end. Then we go to the five squared from this end to this end. So we connect from one corner here to the other corner. Basically, it's diagonally opposite. And then similarly for the eight squared also, we connect from here to its opposite end. And for 13 squared, we connect from here all the way to its opposite end. What is this shape that you can see here? Keep that in your mind. Now, take the same curved line through each of the other grids, from the smallest to biggest, from corner to opposite corner, ending with the 13 squared grid. What we get is a lovely spiral pattern. What is the link between this spiral pattern created by squared Fibonacci numbers and nature? Well, the exact same Fibonacci spiral can be found in nature. Where? Let's see, shall we? So, in this previous page, we saw this thing, right? Same way, we have just now connected all the dots and formed a nice spiral. This curvy thing that we have drawn, this figure, is called a spiral. And we have come up to the 13 squared grid. So let's see how this is linked to nature. Here's the Fibonacci spiral with one more grid, 21 squared, added to our original figure. See how the spiral continues? Does the spiral look familiar? So we have added this huge large square as well to the previous pattern. Remember, we had only up till this violet square. I'll just refresh your memory once more. See, it is like this horizontally, right? When I add the 21 squared, we place this vertically so that I can place the 21 squared here. And from the 13 squared grid, I again connect the 21 squared to the two opposite ends. And look at this, it's another bigger, the spiral is getting bigger. So does this look familiar to you, or have you seen it somewhere before? Let's check out. Of course it does. You can see the Fibonacci spiral in seashells, although you might have to twist your head around a bit to see the exact spiral pattern of the previous page. So now do you see this figure, the spiral pattern? So this is a seashell, which is found in the beach. Snail shells, look at this snail, and yet again we are finding a spiral pattern, its home on its back. Even eggs, see how the spiral goes the other way, anti-clockwise, as compared to the clockwise spiral on page 14. So the previous page had a clockwise. Clockwise meaning the way the clock travels, right? But the clock usually travels in this circle, right? Look at my mouse pointer, how am I turning? But this spiral goes in this direction. So it is anti-clockwise, the way opposite to how the clock turns. Isn't it amazing that egg is also having a spiral pattern? Even larger structures like hurricanes and even some galaxies seem to follow the Fibonacci spiral pattern. Fascinating, isn't it? So hurricanes, you can see the spiral patterns, hurricanes or cyclones that you hear about, they form a spiral pattern. Galaxies that hold billions and billions of stars also form a spiral pattern. Isn't that amazing, interesting, fascinating? A brief history. To end this exciting tale of Fibonacci numbers, let's touch briefly upon the history of the Fibonacci number sequence. In the 11th century, almost 1,000 years ago, a Jain scholar and monk called Hemachandra, who lived in present-day Gujarat, discovered an interesting mathematical pattern while studying poetry and music. He was looking at the number of different ways in which you could combine long and short sounds in music to create different rhythmic patterns. Around 100 years later, an Italian mathematician called Leonardo Fibonacci from 1170 to 1250 Common Era wrote about the very same mathematical pattern in his book Liber Abaci, or Book of Calculation, in 1202. Fibonacci traveled extensively along the Mediterranean coast, meeting merchants from the East and finding out about how they did mathematics. It is possible that Fibonacci came across Hemachandra's sequence during his travels, but since he was the first one to introduce it to Europe, these numbers became known to the world as the Fibonacci sequence. So about 1,000 years ago in the 11th century, in our very own India, in the state now that is called Gujarat, we had a Jain scholar known as Hemachandra, who discovered this mathematical pattern as he was studying music, because he wanted to create different combinations of long and short sounds to form different rhythmic patterns. And that is how he stumbled across this series first. Afterwards, 100 years later, Leonardo Fibonacci, an Italian mathematician, introduced this in Europe. Fibonacci actually traveled a lot along the Mediterranean coast, talking to merchants to find out how they used mathematics. He could have very well come across this Hemachandra sequence of numbers, but Fibonacci was the one who introduced it in Europe, and this is now called as Fibonacci series. I would recommend that all of you search in the internet about Hemachandra series and Fibonacci to get more information on this and how Hemachandra bumped onto this initially. So this is Hemachandra and this is Fibonacci. A word of caution, although there are many examples in nature that seem to follow the Fibonacci pattern, there are also many examples in nature that do not, like four-leaved clovers or flowers with four petals. What's intriguing, though, is how often these Fibonacci numbers do appear in nature. So far, scientists haven't figured out why nature seems to love Fibonacci numbers so much. Maybe you can find the answer when you grow up. So, there are many examples in nature, of course, that follow the Fibonacci pattern. However, there are also many examples in nature that do not follow the pattern. You've seen four-leaved clovers or flowers with four petals. But then, the intriguing part or the curious part or the strange part is these Fibonacci numbers do appear in nature. And we haven't, our scientists haven't figured out why nature loves Fibonacci numbers so much. Maybe you are the one who's going to find out in the future. Thank you. I hope you enjoyed this story and knowing about Fibonacci sequence as well as our own Hemachandra contributing about this 100 years before Fibonacci himself did this in Europe. Thank you. Bye. Some of the difficult words in the story: fascinating, extremely interesting, intriguing, interesting, strange. Try these. Write the Fibonacci sequence up to 20 numbers. Read more about Hemachandra Fibonacci series in the internet and understand more about Hemachandra's discovery. Thank you. Bye-bye.